This AiO has a pump top display with a penthouse view. It's vast, it's spacious, but is it all blue skies? This is the Panorama ARGB 360 from TRYX. And we wanna know if it can keep your CPU cool or if it'll get its head stuck in the clouds. We're about to share everything that we know about it, including how to pronounce the brand's name, right here, right now on Robeytech. I cannot think of another AIO in recent history that had more people talking about it than the Panorama ARGB 360, and for very good reason too. This AIO is an absolute showstopper with its massive Times Square-like panoramic active matrix OLED display front and center. We got to see this thing in person at Computex. In fact, I think we were the first to see and cover it in our short that we showed. And every time we ran into other influencers, we would say, or they would say, have you seen that Panorama AIO from that really weird brand? Was that TRYX or TRYX or we couldn't figure out the name, but we got to it. One thing that was important to us is that we pronounced the brand's name right. So just to be clear, we asked. Now, first and foremost, it's not TRYX, but it's also not TRYX, which is what I thought it was in the first place. And in fact, that's actually what I said when I actually did the whole video on it.
I am here at the TRYX booth.
It's actually pronounced TRYX, as in like tricycle or trike. So am I gonna get that right throughout the video? Yeah, I think I am. I'm gonna give it the old college try out of respect for the company. So let's start with the pricing and where the Panorama AIO lands in comparison to other display equipped AIOs. Now the Panorama AIO comes in three sizes. You got your 240, your 280, your 360, and in either an ARGB or non-ARGB version, which in this case kind of matters. Each size and version are available in either black or white also. At the time of recording this video, we only had the pricing for the 360mm version of the Panorama. Now for the non-ARGB version, we're looking at $339.99. That's pricey. But for the Panorama ARGB 360, you're actually looking at $349.99, $10. That's the price of RGB right there. Now, while that is a pretty penny for a 360mm AIO, that's the price for both the black and white versions. Now, good on TRYX for not taxing PC builders for wanting to use white components. Once it's officially launched in August, you should be able to find these over at Amazon.com. We were also told that CyberPower PC, which I know is true because we've actually seen the advertisements for it, will have a limited quantity of pre-built systems that are actually featuring this AIO. So how do the prices for the Panorama AIOs compare to other display-equipped CPU coolers? Now, at the time of this video, which if you looked at our CH160 video, which you can see right here, things can change between when we record and when it actually comes out. Prices range from $179.99 for the Lee & Lee HydraShift 360S all the way up to $349.99 for the Asus ROG Ryujin 3. So, I mean, it's not an abnormal price. From the price standpoint, these AIOs are kind of in the upper crust of the range, but honestly, are you that surprised, specifically given the screen? Now, with prices on the higher side, do dollars actually translate into broader compatibility? Because Lee & Lee, not necessarily. But here for this one on the Intel side, this actually ends up being true. Panorama AIOs have support for LGA 115X, LGA 1200, and LGA 1700 sockets, which covers all of your Intel Core processors up to 14th gen. Keep in mind that LGA 1851, the socket Intel is actually gonna be using for their upcoming Arrow Lake, is also supposed to be compatible with LGA 1700, even though there's more pins. The socket is actually supposed to be the same, or we're supposed to be able to use the same coolers. Now on the AMD side, TRYX is supporting Ryzen CPUs on both AM4 and AM5, thanks to 8th gen Asetek pump mounting, which is good and makes things easier. So the stock bracket expands to fit either your existing AM4 or AM5 bracket holes. As for the installation process, it was super straightforward, pretty much on both platforms. Outside of just mounting it in, you either use the bracket or you use the full bracket on AMD. So we love to see these user-friendly modern AIOs. Now, since we're talking about the Asetek pump, let's get into the cooling specs for the Panorama AIO. The pump has an operating range of 800 to 2600 RPM with a variance of around plus or minus 400. This pump is also paired with a slightly thicker tubing and radiator. The radiator measures 30 millimeters, which is slightly thicker than the average 27 millimeter rads you've seen on other AIOs like your Corsair H150i, etc. Now, as for fans, there were two models that really differentiate from themselves. And this is where I said ARGB versus non-ARGB is actually very important with this particular model of AIO. The ARGB model, which is the version that we're testing, comes with the TRYX Rota ARGB 120 millimeter fans. These things push 66.09 CFM at an air pressure of 1.54 mmH2O, with an operating noise of around 27.86 decibels. So they're quiet, but those specs are surprisingly bad when you compare them against other ARGB fans. For example, Li & Li's HydroShift 360R ARGB fans push 79.9 CFM at an air pressure of 3.26 mmH2O. Even the Corsair QX120 RGB on the H150Is with a lower CFM of 63.1 still have a high 3.80 mmH2O. And remember, for radiators and cooling through radiators, that 3.8 number is actually very important because that's how effective it is as pushing air through the radiator, which essentially is what cools it. So a number lower than 3, and especially lower than 2, is pretty bad. Now, needless to say, we do have some concerns, but let's see. Let's wait till we get to the actual performance numbers to see if they come to fruition. Now, for the non-ARGB AIO, they use the Rota Pro 120 fans. Now, these are way more performant fans with a CFM of 81.32 at an air pressure of 3.66 mmH2O, which is a whole lot better. Now, they do run slightly louder at 30.97 decibels, but they're not going to sound like a jet engine, so that's actually pretty good. Now, just a note here, these fans do daisy chain together, but they do so by plugging one fan into the next, similar to the Decool. I know that the name's kind of bad to say, but what Decool used to do. Be aware though, you are still gonna have to do some cable management with these fans. And since we're talking about cables to manage, you still have a couple cables to manage with the pump itself. You have a PWM header, and then you also have an internal USB that actually deals with all the screen connecting and all that stuff. Let's talk about the actual display itself, because that's kind of like the whole thing. So to give you a little bit more detail, as we mentioned earlier, this is an active matrix OLED, or an AMOLED. But what I didn't tell you earlier is that this thing has a resolution of 2240 by 1080 and a refresh rate of 60 hertz. This thing is absolutely mesmerizing. In fact, we turned it away from me because I'd probably just sit there and stare at it the whole time.
Oh man, that looks so good.
Now, since it's curved, you can actually get some really cool 3D effects on this thing. TRYX has a library of 3D content for it within their Canali software. Why Canali? I don't know. Canali also gives users control over content scaling, screen customization, and the option to display system information. Standard fare for most modern AIO displays. Now, I do have to say, when I came in to actually change the graphics on this with Brian, I was like, oh, let me just search for it. And I understand that you have cool code names for your software, but can we just call it TRYX control software? Calling it something like Canali, it's not intuitive. And honestly, sometimes like how often do you use it? So like, you're like, man, what is that thing called? Come on, TRYX. Before August, call it TRYX control or something like that, so it's easier to find. Couple things to point out here. Number one, the software only controls the screen. All fan and pump controls happen through the motherboard, which is great for real-time system cooling adjustments overall, but it does mean that the displayed information that you see on the screen is just a tiny bit delayed. We also noticed that the Canali software had very little system overhead, which this is actually cool, where we've seen other AIOs, Li & Li, Corsair, hog up to 13% of the CPU's attention. While those AIOs are out there being super needy for attention, the Panorama already has it. What more could it need? And luckily, that doesn't mean it needs more system resources. So you got that one right, TRYX. Final note here on the screen before we move on to performance, the angle of focus on the screen is more like at the corner. So this is important to know if you're trying to get text to wrap around the screen. There are some angles that might look a bit cattywampus if you're not looking at the corner. And yes, cattywampus was actually on my word of the day calendar. So nailed it. By the way, you owe me 50 bucks. Okay, now it's testing time. Let's see if those amazing fans do an okay job of cooling these systems, and we're gonna find all that right now. But really quick, these things are tested on both identical Intel and AMD rigs, of course, changing the CPUs out in motherboards, but for the most part, this is all done under the same conditions, with the same power settings, etc., trying to make the data as clean as possible. And feel free to just pause the video right here if you wanna make any notes. Okay, how did the actual Panorama perform? At CPU idle, the TRYX Panorama ARGB 360 had an average CPU temperature of 32 degrees Celsius on our Intel platform, while our AMD test bench averaged around 46. This positioned the TRYX AIO next to the Li & Li HydroShift 360R on both sides. While the Panorama 360 was 2 degrees cooler on our Intel test, it was on the warmer side of 46 than the HydroShift, specifically when it came to AMD. In our CPU load test, the story changed. We saw an average temperature temperature of 73 degrees on Intel and 88 degrees on AMD. For comparison on the Intel side, that performance is comparable to the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3 ARGB. But on the AMD side, those numbers put it very close to the ASUS ROG Ryugen 3, putting it in second place in our performance charts. And this is why we test on AMD and Intel. Finally, during our 1440p gaming test, the Panorama ARGB 360 held average temps at 48 degrees Celsius on Intel and 53 degrees on AMD. On the Intel side, that temp put the Panorama right next to the 360 millimeter Fantex Glacier 1D30. And on the AMD side, the Panorama was in contest for third place with Corsair's IQ Link H150i. Basically, the Panorama found its home around the warmer running AIOs we've tested on the Intel side. But for AMD, which loves basically pushing thermal limits, any chance it can basically get, the Panorama showed us a bit more of what it was capable of. But something is holding it back, and we think we know what it is, and that's those fans. Now, they're incredibly lacking, and the deficit showed up in our testing. Now, for comparison, when we looked at the ARGB fans of the equally priced and equally luxurious Ryugen 3, the TRYX ROTA ARGB fans provide 3.98 less CFM than the Ryugen ARGB fans and less than half the static pressure too. We're talking about the difference between the ROTA's 1.54 mmH2O and the Ryugen's 3.88 mmH2O. Now the difference is significant, but that isn't an isolated example. Look at how many times Corsair's IQ Link H150i matched or beat the Panorama in our tests, even with a weaker pump and thinner radiator. We're convinced that this is because of the fans and just how lacking they are overall. Okay, so is it worth it? And this is gonna be such a loaded question. Okay, so let's look at the relative value before we get into our opinion very deeply. Here's the fancy math. It's CPU thermal max, which in this case is 100 degrees Celsius for Intel, minus the CPU temperature under load. Then we divide that number by the retail price, which gives us a dollar per degree of value, cooling value, which we can then score and compare, which in what we really want is lower being better. And then again, this is just literally saying how good it is in terms of cost for its actual job, which is cooling. Nothing else really matters. Now, these numbers are based on the data we collect for our Intel benchmarks, and we use the most up-to-date pricing, and these values will, of course, change over time. Now, with a relative value score of 9.26, the TRYX Panorama ARGB 360 is positioned in value closest to the ASUS ROG Strix LC3, which we'll be talking about here very soon, at 9.40, and the Corsair IQ Link H150i RGB at 8.45. So the Panorama lands in a place where it's neither really cost conscious nor outlandishly overpriced when you think about its performance. But let's be honest, come on. If you're watching this review and you're looking at this AIO, this doesn't look like a budget AIO. You are looking for the luxurious, beautiful AMO LED screen. That's not gonna be cheap. So with all that in mind, it leaves us with the one question on whether or not the TRYX Panorama ARGB 360 is worth considering for your next AIO. Simply put, the Panorama ARGB 360 is not the best performing AIO we've seen. But that's not to say it's bad. When we look at both Intel and AMD, it performed well enough to keep your CPU in safe operating condition at idle, under load, and while gaming. The Panorama really shined on AMD though, so if you're an AMD builder, you're probably pretty happy about this, tying for third in our gaming test while muscling its way to second place under heavy CPU loads. Our recommendation really kind of boils down to this. If you're building a PC that you honestly, you want it to look amazing and you're unbothered by a little bit of extra heat, especially on the Intel side, go for it. The TRYX Panorama ARGB 360 gets the job of cooling done in gaming and CPU workload scenarios. However, if you want to take this AIO from good to great, we might want to consider doing some better performing fans, and it'll still look incredible. Like everything with PC building, you need to ask yourself what you need this AIO to do for you. With an AIO like this, I think you already know the answer. You need a system to look and be immediately eye-catching. And if that's your goal, the TRYX Panorama ARGB 360 is one of the most memorable AIOs we have seen to date. Now, if you're saying I don't need all the flash and I just need it to cool like a massive freaking heat puller, then come on, why are you watching this review? You know this isn't the right one for you. So those were our thoughts on the TRYX Panorama ARGB 360 AIO, but we wanna know what you think. What do you think of that beautiful wraparound display, which they won't let me see because I'll just stare at it? And then do you think pumps and sizes and stuff like this are actually kind of the future? And would you like to see more kind of things like this? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. And if you want to continue the conversation, talk more about builds or what AIOs to use, etc., head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to have these conversations continue it with other like-minded PC and tech enthusiasts. And you know what? You might just have the greatest conversation and make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us at Robeytech everywhere on social media. Thank you so much for watching. We look forward to seeing you on the next video. Now, let me look at the screen.